This is Information Service Engineering, lecture number 13, ISE Applications, part 1. This is an excursion in this lecture because we want you to learn how to read box plots. What are box plots? So I can show you what a box plot is. So box plot is something that you use in descriptive statistics, and it's a method for graphically depicting groups of numerical data together through the so-called quartiles. So this kind of visualization was already introduced in the 1950s. So the whiskers that you see and the box that has then been introduced in the 1970s by John Turkey. And it's a standardized way of displaying this data set based on a 5, sometimes 6 number summary. So what you see here, the summary on the left side is what you have. You have a minimum, a maximum, you have a median and a first and the third quartile. And sometimes you also have given the mean somewhere. Okay, let's have a quick look. The median, what's the median? The median is the value that separates the higher half from the lower half of the data. So if you have n data, at n divided by 2, there's the median. You can have a look at our data, for example. If you compare it to the minimum and maximum, so the minimum, here is at minus 86. The maximum is by plus 1,329 and the median is at 17. So you see that most of the values, 50% of the values, lie below the median, so between minus 86 and 17. So this gives you already some idea of the distribution of the data. Okay, then there are the quartiles. The first quartile, Q sub 1, is defined as the middle number between the smallest number and the median of the data set. So this means this is then 25% of the data. And the third quartile is the middle value between the median and the highest value of the data set. And again then, between these two quartiles, this is the so-called interquartile range. There you find already 50% of the data, and you see here that 50% of the data is between 3 and 51. So this gives you further ideas about the distribution of your data. So what then are these whiskers you see here? So these whiskers are indicating variability outside the upper and lower quartiles. So any data not included between the whiskers should be considered as an outlier of your data. And a possible definition that also comes from John Turkey, who introduced these whiskers, is to limit the length of the whiskers to a maximum of 1.5 times the interquartile distance that you have there. However, the whiskers does not end exactly after this length, but after the value from the data that still lies within this limit. This is how it works. And of course, we will need this kind of box plots then to make sense of the data that we have acquired in the last part of the lecture. So in the next part of the lecture, we want to go deeper into this data and analyze this data also with the help of box plots in a new Python collaborative notebook that we have prepared for you. But this you will see in the next part of the lecture.